Doing these last couple of videos has made me think about the nature of tillering, and it's one of those things, it's all about feel. It's very easy to make hard and fast statements, yes, pull it to full draw weight unless the tiller looks good. But the reality obviously is a bit more difficult. But it also depends what bow you're making. If you're making something with plenty of length and plenty of timber there, yes, you can pull it to full weight almost without thinking, like a roughed out war bow stave, yeah, just pull it because it's not going to break. Something like this, which is a relatively short bow, it's only about 55 inches long, so half of 55, about 28 inches roughly. So theoretically you should be able to pull it to 28 inches, but this idea of you can pull it to half the length of the bow is fine for a perfect stave, bend through the handle, evenly tillered. But of course a little bit of scruffy elder like this with big knots on it, it's not a perfect stave. If it was 20 pounds I could pull it to 28 inches probably no problem. If you get a very thin slat of timber you can bend it right back round on itself. So it's all about compromise. Yeah, you heard that, all about compromise. There was a rather acrimonious post on Facebook where someone had made a £185 war bow out of Osage, and it was, I think it was about 74, 76 inches long, and some guy from the States who's very good at making Native American bows and what have you said, it doesn't need to be that long for a 30 inch draw. Well, it doesn't need to be that long for a 30 inch draw if it's pulling 60 pounds, but 180 pounds, it needs to be long. So there are no hard and fast rules, which is why it looks in these videos as if I'm ignoring my own advice. I haven't pulled it to full draw weight yet. I've got very close. I've got to do it at some point, haven't I? Will it go bang? Will it survive? But you'll see the tiller's looking much better now. And that was the point I was making before. If the tiller's looking right, you can pull a bit more. I think we're still looking a bit weak on that left limb there. The right can come back more. But I found before, the more I pulled it, the better the tiller looked. The tiller appears to change as you draw it. So it's no good tillering it to look good at 20 if when you pull it to 30 and 35 you suddenly start seeing the errors creeping in. And that's the point. When you see the errors creeping in and you think, hang on, that's not looking right, that's when you've got to quit. It's that listening to the inner voice, that little inner voice that says, hang on, that's not right, I'll just pull it a little bit more. No, quit. Like that, I can see, yeah, that's looking quite good, but that right limb, it's still not bending as much as the left. That left's working quite hard. Sort of, I think I'm pointing in the right direction. But this right one, it's still stiff there. All right, I'm only at 30. There's 35. But I'm not far off the 40, and I'm pulling that 22. But I'd just be foolhardy to keep pulling that, because it's going to go bang on those knots. I've got to get this moving a bit more. I don't know, does that make sense? Am I going round in circles? Am I actually telling you anything? You can read all the books, you can do what you want, but at the end of the day, you've got to make a bow. You've got to pull it. If you want a 40-pound bow, you've got to pull it to 40 at some point. And only you can decide when that point is. And as someone once said, if you ain't breaking them, you ain't making them. I don't know if I'm being unduly nervy with this. I've been easing off this right limb, trying to get it to come round a bit more. But there's this slight reflex there, makes it look a bit deceptive. But tiller's looking better. And as the tiller looks better, so I'm pulling it further. I don't know if you can see, that's looking better. And it's much closer to the white chalk lines on the... Yeah. So it's easy to over-concentrate on one limb and forget the other. But now that right limb's working more. In danger, looking slightly stiff there. It's all looking much more balanced. I should just pull it straight back to 40 now, but I've just been teasing this so much that it's made me twitchy. And you know, that's one of the dilemmas, isn't it? You're just frightened of it going bang. There's a good 35. Oh, we're nearly 40 at 24. That's 24 inches, so I've got my 24 inch tool. We're not far off.